to this, they're just not, you're too much for them. But like, that doesn't mean that something's wrong with you, that means something's wrong with those people. So sometimes we as Christians, we think we're too anything. We're just, we're too in everybody's face, you know? We want to stand back because we're like, I don't really want to step on anybody's toes. I don't want to be the center of attention. I don't want to stand out because I don't want to have to, I don't want to put myself in the center. I don't want to be looked at. I don't want to be analyzed by the people because they may find mistakes. They may find problems or things to take issue with. So we don't want to be too noticed sometimes. Especially, and that's what he talks about in this day and time, I feel like sometimes Christians have a tendency to play the victim. We feel like, well, I don't want to be noticed because people are always, you know, hating on Christians. They always think that we're this, or we think that we don't love people, or we think we're doing things wrong, or everybody has something to take issue with. And he was like, well, I wanted this song to be kind of a call to that part of us, to that, to the Christians that are facing battles, and they try to push them away because they're scared to lose them. I don't want to put myself out there because what if I fail? I don't want to put myself in the center of attention because what if people find mistakes? What if I'm doing something wrong and somebody notices it? Then I'm ruined, right? But that's us holding ourselves to a standard that is not reachable. That's not God holding us to that standard. In the Bible, and what he says is, in the Bible is the constant reminder that God is not trying to put us on the spot and make us feel weak and make us feel wrong and make us feel broken or messed up. God has constantly reminded us in his word that he is our refuge. Do not be afraid. Have courage. I am with you. The thing that we forget sometimes is when we put ourselves out there, when we are bold, when we stand up for what we believe in, it's not, we focus too much on the things that could go wrong. And that's true, that could happen. But in the Old Testament especially, they faced many battles, different people, God's people, faced all kinds of different battles, physical battles, emotional battles, you know, any battle that these people had to go through in order to be the people of God. He was with them the whole time. He says it countless times. I am with you. Do not be afraid. This battle is not yours. It belongs to God. And so I feel like sometimes we shy away from being bold and standing up for what we believe in because we don't want to be hurt. We don't want to be put down. We don't want the world to tear us down. But if we don't stand up and if we don't stand out, we are doing that to ourselves. We're tearing ourselves down. We're holding ourselves back. And so we're not allowing ourselves that opportunity to be a part of what God's doing. And I don't know if y'all noticed this, but there's not a single thing that God did in this Bible that wasn't bold, that wasn't shocking. It didn't stand out, right? The whole Bible is full of those people who were just different, who everybody was like, oh, look at that person. They're crazy. And they were the best disciple for God. They did what his work needed to be done. They did what he needed at that time, and it changed lives because they took that leap of faith. And that's kind of what this song is talking about. If you're gonna follow God, you cannot do it halfway. You cannot do it, you know, only when you feel like it, and you cannot do it in the background without it. You have to be bold. You have to be able to be noticed, and you have to be willing to stand out and stand up for what you believe in. In fact, I think there's a T-shirt in our youth room that says something to that effect. Stand out when you stand up for what you stand for.
Yes.
It was like an LCGYF youth convention, and I love it, but we cut out those T-shirts and put them on the youth, the walls in the youth room, and Mom tried to rearrange it one time, and I told her she couldn't touch it. I was like, no, you can't touch it. It's like a thing. We have to leave. Nobody goes in there, but we can't move it because I need all those up there. But anywho, here are some examples, and he had a couple, but I just took some of them. One is from 2 Chronicles, from one of those battles that we were talking about with Jehoshaphat. It says, then Jehoshaphat stood in the assembly of Judah and Jerusalem in the Lord's temple before the new courtyard. He said, Lord God of our ancestors, are you not the God who is in heaven, and do you not rule over all the kingdoms of the nations? Power and might are in your hands, and no one can stand against you. Are you not our God who drove out the inhabitants of this land before your people Israel, and who gave it forever to the descendants of Abraham your friend? They have lived in the land and have built you a sanctuary in it for your name, and have said, if disaster comes on us, sword or judgment, pestilence. or famine, we will stand before this temple and before you, for your name is in this temple. We will cry out to you because of our distress, and you will hear and deliver. And then later it says, you do not have to fight this battle. Position yourselves and stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. He is with you, Judah and Jerusalem. Do not be afraid or discouraged. Tomorrow, go out and face them, for the Lord is with you. And then later, in Corinthians, Paul, who says great things all the time, and if there was ever a bold follower of God, Paul's a really good example of that. And he's talking to the Corinthians, and he says, now I, Paul, myself, appeal to you by the meekness and gentleness of Christ, who I do am humble among you in person, but bold toward you when absent. I beg you that when I am present, and I will not need to be bold with the confidence by which I plan to challenge certain people who think we are behaving according to the flesh. For although we live in the flesh, we do not wage war according to the flesh, since the weapons of our warfare are not of the flesh, but are powerful through God for the demolition of strongholds. We demolish arguments and every proud thing that is raised up against the knowledge of God, and we take every thought captive to obey Christ. And that was a strange scripture for me to pull out of Corinthians, but the reason I pulled it out is because one part of it is one of the ones he talks about in his devotion, and I made it more because this is Paul saying, I am going to come and help you, but I want you to be willing to do what I tell you and to change. I need you to be flexible a little bit to what I'm telling you because it is of the Lord. And he said, we are not here to become part of this world and use this world to fight our battles. And he's not talking about physical battles. Paul's talking about the people who, I guess, look for mental and emotional ways of combating Christianity. There are those who will try to tell you you're wrong, and they'll try to logic it out and say, this cannot be, and your God is not real. And we're not meant to fight them back with more worldly things, with more worldly examples, because that's not God. God is not of this world. We are meant to fight back with God's warfare, with the love that God has given us in our hearts. It's so much greater than any logic this world could come up with, is the power of God, and it defies all logic. That's the point, is that this world can't do anything close to what our God can accomplish. And Paul's saying, you have to be willing to take what God has given you and use that boldly and confidently, because there is no other way. Nothing this world can give you can you have confidence in like you can in the power of God and what he has given you. And I think that's what I would like to encourage to you today. Let's not passively live a life for God. I want us to actively and boldly live that life for God. So, just to reiterate, the song says, if we're going to fly, we fly like eagles, arms out wide. If we're going to fear, we fear no evil. We will rise. And that's what I want us to do today. Like, if you're going to, those are all of the world. But we're not going to do things like the world wants us to do. We're going to make them greater because we're going to do them the way God wants them to be done. And that's my encouragement for us today. So I'll pray with you and then I'll let you go. Dear God, I thank you.